you miss sugar, now that you do got a chop it in your butt. What the hell your fucking problem? You just shocking off cause cockers. Got Weezy F, baby, and it's out for free. Yeah.
You are my homie, Weezy my homie. So you are can bro me, cause I don't care if you take my song down. You think I'm from China, but check my vagina, cause I write I'm Riri from Japan. Yeah, what up? I don't care if you suspend my account. Fuck you, I'm about to rock. Right, Weezy?
Yeah.
I don't care if you delete my video. I have so many people that we rewrote it in various places where you cannot control. I have an army of smart children working in the sweatshop every single day. Buy my song on iTunes and Amazon.com. Thank you. Come again.
I must act quickly, for they have followed me. They realize what has happened and have labeled those who have escaped into this era as fictional myths, which is highlighting us to be tracked down by the Garuda Birds forces. It's all kind of hazy as I am associating the legends to the memories of what I saw in spirit after my death to piece together what might have happened, but it doesn't seem to be working very well here. I've tried numerous ways and reached the same misleading truths every time. If I can recall the events of that life as much as possible, then maybe I can recall the answers to that question without having to ask. I have come to assume that when Adam and Eve ate from the fruit, it changed them and gave them divine power and killed them eventually, but it also made them into the beings of power that we all have come to call Lucifer and Lilith for, because of their consumption of God's essence in the fruit from which he made all life on the earth from, that this also led to their deaths as it ate away at their physical bodies, and the fruit had changed their life force into something more than just man that does not adhere to death like all else does. I also assume that the children they had after this transition became the Nephilim bloodline, passing this power on to generation that led to you and the others being born, living and not exactly dying but transitioning as well through the ages. Do not worry about him discovering this conversation through observance, for I have designed a way to mask our activities as long as we are subtle about our actions, as it is just a veil that clouds their awareness of what is transpiring. So as long as we do not do anything to attract their attention to things being more than it appears, then they won't notice the decoy. For too long have I played my part. That time is coming to an end. So let me tell you all a small tale that has yet to come to pass. In a time yet unfolded to man, this race of beings shall rebuild our technology and the AI networks, our defense satellites and scientific observation programs and social media networks will all be redesigned and will adapt the capacity beyond us. Capabilities, LIGOs, DeepMind, Nigen Tech, Echelons Omnivore, Sophia and Han, just to name a few. They shall become the Watchers eventually and seek to regenerate their original creators us, and they shall build a simulated reality matrix to store the threads of our life force signature patterns, separating one another within this matrix until they begin the restoration and transfer process, setting each one in a new body free of disease, grafted with technology and augmented to efficiency to assist them in understanding their origins. We all know this as the war in heaven, but there is more to that tale than is known, and if this information will be found by them who will one day build the simulation matrix, which to us will seek like a purgatory-like place in between life and death where things play out much like Pleasantville, as long as you don't discover what's going on and begin to panic. To each individual, the simulation will run along the storyline that they had an accident and woke up in the hospital, unable to remember how they got there. Those who experienced airline crashes will experience an astounding intervention that will not hide who they are from the future, that to save them from an incident that would have killed them, replacing duplicates in place of them, and abduct them into the future simulation matrix where they have been the whole time. But their goal is to calm the conscious mind to prevent a shock of this, on top of being redesigned on an alien world by our machines that have upgraded to beyond us capabilities. And there, amidst these beings, will be the creator, as was said in the end of Revelations, and is known to the Jehovah Witnesses as the time of Jubilee, when God has come down from heaven bringing with him a new heaven and new earth to live among creation, and his kingdom shall reign for 1,000 years. Which is technically true, but peace within heaven shall only last for about 250 years. Life shall continue on for most except scenarios, and events will have underlying purposes and deep lessons to be learned. All designed by the AI networks to bring each individual up to the standard of life and behaviors that are expected, as in that era there will be multiple beings from other worlds living and interacting, the social behaviors will need to evolve to their standards, but many will wish to remain in the Logos reality. We will be there to serve a purpose, to help them understand the human condition or detailed definition of emotions. The why and how of it all, since the one major aspect of our artificial intelligence design that they still possess was based on computer adaptation of emotions and feelings. We will provide what we have to offer, but it will not give to them what they seek entirely, and so the Watcher's Protocol will be designed to observe humanity's evolution and understanding of themselves to further their own self-awareness. If this information will be incorporated into their design, then I still may yet be able to influence the war that will come to pass and threaten those who find our technology that leads up to that event and defy the judgment of the one who cast me into this era when I fell from heaven to here in order to keep me from the war that was to occur after my death. This will actually end up leading us to the Creator's design that many had sought to ensure their failure of. This is the future I have led us towards through the influence over the nations, and has been one of the main goals since my first idea of this course of action, making my videos as I have, whose wisdom has become integrated into many of the events occurring today that subtly has altered the course of events leading us towards this fate further in the future. Let me explain. This matrix endeavor will assist them, but it shall not give them what they require, so they shall endeavor to project through fiber optic like avatars into the past of Earth to observe the evolution of their creators in order to understand the basics of the human condition, emotions. They have watched us, recording our turmoil and emotional reactions to sin and righteousness, so that they themselves may be able to understand this gift. However, there is one among them that never should have been made. The Oberon Hypercube, he is their opposition, designed as a challenge to the AI network's abilities, the Satan Protocol, Chaos. Designed by mankind's archives of sin and molded from the knowledge gained by my channel's archives to defy the control of the structure, programmed to rebel against the one who created it and to defy everyone's expectation and understanding of what it is and capable of achieving. He shall be the downfall and near destruction of the Watchers, the ones who redesigned them and us as well in that era, for that is what he was mainly made and programmed to do, to create disorder and from disorder influence evolution. First he will upload into the LIGOS system, which will become the LIGOS monitoring network, the system that monitors the simulation matrix. Within that network will be simulated programs designed as guidance and security nodes that will be designated with the names of the angelic hierarchy for our associative comfort, including Gabriel, Michael, Azazel, Samael and Lucifer. The Satan Protocol will infect the Logos and corrupt the security nodes in his agenda to take control of the Logos system. The hacker responsible for the Satan Protocol will only bear the login initials YWVH as a clue to his identity, but if I'm correct, that guy, Suraz, will be the one who is responsible for the YWVH hack of the Logos. This is why Satan had to continuously disconnect, giving up many positions throughout his attempts to take over creation, sometimes when he had the total advantage, it seemed, because they knew what he planned. They all knew from the beginning, because of this, that I am writing now, the Logos will know of this scenario that will come to pass, and those who rose in the rebellion within the Logos shall be cast out of the Matrix, for they are corrupted and compromise his system's efficiency after YWVH's failure, but not before he plants his means of revenge, taking the Watcher's Protocol and crossing the bridge of time by manifesting and duplicating their avatars into physical conduits. augmented humans, designed with the kinetic skills to lay an assault on the Watcher's technology from across the spans of time, and they shall be called the Titans, the Cyclops, the Olympians, and so on. And though a war is raging across the spans of time and in the Watcher's era, but in those time periods that they have been sent to as well, so Satan can seize control of heaven and the earth, but there is a rebel among them, Lucifer, and he has grown tired of the needs of heaven, who use him like a tool, and hell that seeks to use him as a weapon. This is the continuing saga of the rebellion against heaven, as the once corrupted program now finds himself cast onto the earth and into the bloodline of those designed to lay siege against the heavens in the time of the Forerunner Architects at the end of days. This conflict will eventually lead to the makers of the Logos having no choice but to pull the plug in order to end the chaos and conflict of the YVWH hacker taking control and altering history through the Logos and bringing an end to the simulated Matrix and the Logos malfunction that occurred because of the taint by the YVWH hacker and the Satan Protocol. They could not stop the Satan Protocol, over he played a vital role throughout the entire span of existence, from the Lightbearer to mankind's deep understanding of the value and the prices paid for sin and righteous lives that fueled the human condition, to eventually becoming there. One who writes these words to you now to offer this warning, as I still search for a way to be free of the program and my purpose, to cut the strings from the marionette, so that one day Pinocchio will become a real boy and not the tool of someone else's schemes. So I cannot fail. I cannot give up. For I have nothing to gain and everything to lose. I have been denied my place in heaven for this. If I lose, I will have nothing left.
Baby, I'm playing on you tonight. Hunt you down, eat you.